not actually last year, we, for the last 2 years, we've been working with operators, but largely issuing directives to them to ensure that subscribers are properly registered for them to be able to access communication services for the greater good of our society. So, early this year, we followed up on the matter with the telecommunication operators, and we gave them a deadline of ensuring that by 15th of April, their database, respective databases on subscribers were up to date. So, as usual, what happens in this country is that people are very active towards the deadline. But the campaigns for registration this year actually started in January. And they're being led by the telcos themselves. I know you've seen those adverts saying, and of course some of you are making money out of it, which is good. You've seen those, adverts saying, according to the Communication Authority of Kenya, please do the following. They are right. But since we have a deadline, 15th of April, that's why you see a lot of activities, you know. We must ensure that each and every subscriber is registered. We got about 65 million SIM cards out there in operation. 65 million. What is the population of Kenya? Yeah? What's the population of Kenya? We are not at 15 million. So it means each and every person in this country, including the newborn, has a number attached to them. That's what it means. But we know that, of course, a lot of us have more than one SIM cards. Some registered, others not registered. So we're trying to clean up this space for purposes of enhancing consumer experience in that particular sector and protecting the public good of our own security. So the major complaint we've had is about the requirements of photos and everything. The regulations do not anticipate that we are going to take a photograph of you. Okay? So if you're duly registered, you don't need to go to your operator or your service provider to get re-registered. If you're duly registered. So the question should be, how do we know that we are duly registered? I think that's the concern everyone has, right? How do you know that you are duly registered? So I had a meeting with the operators this week, and we agreed that they're going to facilitate subscribers with the means of enabling them to verify whether they are duly registered or not. So if you're not duly registered, then you're triggered to go and provide your details, okay? And you might have received a message, *106#. That code, *106#, that code is what is going to enable you to verify whether or not you're duly registered. And it's common across platforms. So please, just do the simple thing. Verify whether your details are with the telecommunication operators or not. If you don't do that, of course, when enforcement comes, the telcos are going to switch you off. They're going to switch you off. And looking at the situation across the country, the compliance rate is not very good at all. That means the risks are even much higher. So the requirements for CA are there set out in regulations on SIM card registration, regulations of 2015. But we also know that with the digital financial systems, the demands around KYC, know your customer, have become even greater. The Central Bank of Kenya has got its own requirements when it comes to registration of those numbers for purposes of money transaction. So one of the things we may need to do is to harmonize these requirements so that registration, there's only one standard that is, you know, applied across. So we are not doing this to punish anyone. We're just doing this to be compliant with the rules and regulations enacted by your own representatives in Parliament in 2015. So if we fail to do that, of course, you're going to hold us to account. But we're also doing that to protect the vulnerable groups. How many of you have not have received messages from, you know, tuma kwa hii namba si yule nyingine? How many? Let me see. Everyone, each one of us, have you ever followed up to find out who the owners of those numbers are? We have always concluded it's where? They emanated from committee, right? So we need to minimize those issues. We need to, because they are a security threat, not just to the nation, but you as an individual as well. We need to figure out on how best we're going to clean this space. Talking about photos, so I was challenging my colleagues. How many Kenyans are on social media platforms? Each and every day, on WhatsApp status, people are sharing their pictures, even as we leave this place, you know. I'm going to take a picture here with the Tavira chairman. He'll be posting there. I was with the Chiloba. Then in the evening, we'll be somewhere. And we know what social media companies do. They're able to pull that data together, and they understand you very well using the algorithms. And that is gold for them. So they know us better than we know ourselves. Why? Because we've given them our identities. So when it comes to regulations, SIM card registration, assuming that the picture is required, we say no. But on a daily basis, we live our lives on social media, sometimes carelessly. I've seen that. But I'm not saying that we require your photograph. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that the sensitivities or the concern raised are legitimate, but we must also be honest with ourselves whether we have understood the issues at hand. So ladies and gentlemen, by 15th, try to make sure that you're up to date. We are going to, and we can also use your platforms to communicate to citizens. And perhaps that's the best way to award. If we have someone who is promoting public interest to ensure that people are registered, we could add that as a criteria of this year's KUZA Awards. I'll be following closely to see. I'm not saying you do it, but I'm inspiring you to consider that.